Yes, you know, I've heard that. I thought that's an old card, you know, open up, you know, and you know, I was a little bit concerned because I was not sure that was a punch or headbutt, you know, but I just tried to focus, do my best, you know, and I know he was coming, so I have to sit down and hit him with a couple punches and move around. You know, he was a tough guy, coming with the white punches, you know, he really surprised me in some moments of this fight. And, you know, then after I was trying just to get to the fourth round because, you know, if it stopped before, maybe if that was a punch, I'm taking a chance to lose the fight too, you know. So I was trying to bring it, just protect myself and I just keep fighting, you know, work off the jab and hit whatever I see.
When you speak of the angle, was it confusing when you returned from southpaw to orthodox?
You know, I don't have a trouble fighting with the southpaws. I got in my Atlantic City boxing lab, Shimon Alvarez. I got a lot of work with him. He's a good southpaw fighter. And if he's turning a southpaw, I just, you know, no different. I know what to do. Just, you know, keep that jab in his face, you know, and keep hitting him to the body. Actually, when they turn southpaw, I try to hit them a couple times stronger. So they got confused and they turn back to the orthodox.
He seemed like a tough guy that was able to take a lot of punishment. Going into that eighth round, did you think you would still have a chance to stop him like you did?
No, I didn't look for a knockout. You know, not, if you're looking for a knockout, you're never going to find it. I was just boxing. You know, last round, I tried to relax, you know, be cautious, be careful, you know, because he was throwing some bombs, you know, and I put some combination together and I took him out.
What did it mean for you to hear the crowds chanting your name and chanting Paul Scott, Paul Scott? Is that inspiring when you get to
hear? Yeah, that was a big motivation. He was coming, you know, hitting with couple punches, but I was thinking to myself, no way you're going to take me out through my crowd, or, you know, close to me. So I was just keep coming, you know. I have a big heart to fight and I'm always coming in the shape. So I fight him all rounds.
I know it's early yet, but how bad do you think the cut is and how long is it going to keep you out?
Yeah, cut is pretty bad. Usually they take it, you need 100 days to heal it perfect, you know. But no matter what, just stay in the gym, keep working, get better. And as soon as the cut heal, we're going to see what's coming next.
What's the number one lesson you learned tonight from this hard fight?
Move your head. If you stop moving your head, they move it for you.
Very tired in the last half of the fight. Weren't there times that you thought you could take him out like we did? I thought you would. He was very tired. I knew it. He seemed to get revitalized after the minute rest. And then after the first half minute of the next round, he was, his legs were out under him.
You know what, you're right, but I was, after like two rounds, I think to myself, I'm going to stop hitting him, because whatever I hit him strong, he's coming back stronger at me. So I was thinking, if I stop hitting him, he maybe won't come to me. So, but to answer on your question, yeah, he was taking some punches, you know, I got him hurt, you know, but I think I should follow more after I got him here. I should try finish him, but I was also trying to not punch myself out. You know, just, I know I got a guy hurt, so, but keep working the same thing. Jab, set it up, the other punches, and maybe you take him out. Yes, yes.
You steal the show tonight?
I don't know, Thomas is a big champion. All other fighters, Saddam Ali and everybody who fought undercards, Gabriel Rosado, and that my friend who's speaking half Polish over there too. You know, they all gave a good show, and you know, everybody try give all heart to the fight. So I don't know, I was just doing my job.
What did it mean for you to be on the same card with Tomas and the idea that, you know, you both have Polish background and he's almost blazed the trail for a lot of other, you know, Polish natives that have come here, and is that, you know, is there a sense of pride in the fact that you were on the same card with him?
Yes, it is. It is a big thing for me because, you know, my name is starts existing on this, you know, it's a boxing world. It's a, like, especially here in the United States, it's a big world because it's a lot of fighters, you know, and I, to fight on that kind of big show, I started to be recognizing, you know, on this show. That's why it's a, you know, big pleasure to fight on that kind of shows. Come on, people, any questions?
Oh, you got this down.
Okay,
all right, that's all. Thank you so much, and have a good night. What you talking about?